Frack On to episode of Frack the Canon. I am joined by the coolest mother frackers around, Mr. CJ McCree from Milwaukee. What is up, good sir?
What's up, dude? I am pretty cool.
That's right. Pretty cool. And then my other name is the other Renee, Girl Renee. What's up, Renee?
Not much. Hi.
How are you doing?
Doing all right.
All right. Good to hear. I'm glad you're able to join us. So we are going to react to the Marvel Studios Thor Love and Thunder trailer in 3, 2, 1, play.
These hands were once used for battle. Now they're but humble tools for peace. I need to figure out.
That's a child of mine?
Exactly, yes. Who I am.
I feel like he stole Thanos' retirement plan.
I want to choose my own path. Live in the moment. My superheroing days are over.
Look at me. No longer like a superhero.
That's obviously Zeus.
Remember what I told you. You ever feel lost? Just look into the eyes of the people that you love. Me?
What? Just listening.
Oh my god.
Yes.
That's so hot.
Interesting.
I like that a lot. Takeaway thoughts, reactions?
Well, for me, I feel like it's a little early. Similar, you and I were talking about like how I feel about Thor 3. Thor 3 is my favorite Thor. But like, and I like Taika Waititi, but he didn't nail it in a way where I'm like, oh, you're gonna nail this one. You know what I mean? And this trailer didn't bring it to me in a way where it's like, oh, you're gonna nail this one. I'm still cautiously optimistic. I'm really excited for Thor Love and Thunder. I don't know yet. You know what I mean? There were some like real pacing issues, I think, with part three. And I don't think, you know, like the trailer looks really cool and funny. You know what I mean? It looks like it has a lot of the same charm from the last one. And like I was talking about, Chris Hemsworth, chocolatey beautiful voice a couple of minutes ago. Freaking, you know what I mean? Like, I'm sure it'll be fun. I'm just basically saying I'm cautiously optimistic, but rambling too much. All right.
Renee?
I'm definitely interested in seeing this film because I like CJ, I liked film 3 of the Thor series.
Mm-hmm.
And because it's by Taika Waititi, it's going to be good. It's going to be a fun time. I'm just curious to see what direction it's going to go, especially with Jane as the new Thor.
So that's what I'm most excited myself is to see is Natalie Portman come back as Thor. What I really want to see is GM Alexander, because like the rumor is she's going to be back. That's kind of the rumor, right? But like you said, I'm like, I was talking to CJ about this. Like, I love Ragnarok. But I'm like, there's no real story in Ragnarok. It's just like one big joke. And then I'm like, oh, you have to go from here to here. We have to go from Asgard to Planet Hulk, kind of, to bring Hulk to our team, to go to Asgard. I'm like, it's not really a story. But I thought, I don't know, maybe I haven't watched that movie in a long time.
I would actually, my argument would be like that Thor 3 is the opposite of that. Like whereas you were saying, it's not much story. To me, like Thor 3 has so many things going on.
Okay.
The impact of the things happening, like, is lost. Because when I like, if I just like recount, like thinking about the stuff that happens in Thor 3, so many epic things happen. The Warriors 3 get killed.
Right.
Odin
better
dies.
Not kill Jamie. I got this movie.
Right, like they get killed. Odin dies. Like we find out some whole crazy history from like before all the Marvel movies, you know what I mean, having to do with like how Odin like took over Asgard, you know what I mean? Like, and like this sort of bloodstained, you know what I mean? Like war torn, like soil that Asgard is built upon, you know what I mean? Like so many crazy things happen in Thor Ragnarok, but that's what keeps me cautious about this one. Cause it's like the impact of those things were lost in Thor Ragnarok. You know what I mean? True. Like, because I didn't really feel the impact of the entirety of Asgard being on the run from like an oppressive force. You know what I mean? Like I didn't feel the impact of that. You know what I mean? Cause there's so much going on. And that's why I'm just cautious. Cause it's like so much crazy stuff did happen in Thor Ragnarok. You know what I mean? Asgard got destroyed for crying out loud. You know what I mean? Like freaking crazy things happen, but it's like when those things happen in that movie, I didn't feel the weight of those things though. Right. You know what I mean? Asgard gets destroyed and it's almost kind of played as a joke. The Warriors 3 pretty much die off camera except for Hogan. You know what I mean? Like, a lot of that stuff with them taking over, like the Asgard is like just talked about, you know what I mean? But a thought that I had about this trailer, yes, since I'm spending a lot of time talking about Ragnarok, the thought that I had about this trailer, I was just speculating. Like, I wonder if it'll be as simple as for Jane taking over, because we get the thoughts of Thor saying like he's quitting superheroing, you know what I mean?
Right.
And I'm like, I wonder if it'll be just as simple as like some kind of like corporate like thing. We just needed to fill the spot. So, you know what I mean? We need a new Thor. If you're gonna give up, then we need a new one, you know what I mean? And that's how she is. You know?
Affirmative action, like godness. That's why I want to know how did Mjolnir get like, because we can see the cracks in the trailer.
Like it got reconstructed back together.
Like who did though? Like who reconstructed it? Because we didn't see a villain, and the movie's supposed to come out July 8th. So we're almost 2 months away.
So yeah. There's some, from what I've seen in other trailer breakdowns.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, in the comic books, Mjolnir reforged itself because Jane has proved herself worthy to wield Mjolnir.
Like, but in that same comic books, like Thor lost his ability because he was no longer worthy. Yeah, like Thor was deemed not worthy by Odin to be. So I'm like, they're obviously not gonna do this, and I'm assuming they're not gonna do this based on this trailer. That's what I mean. Going back to, because like they have Christian Bale as the God Butcher. I'm like, okay, let me see that motherfucker. Where's he?
Yeah, he wasn't in the trailer. I'm excited to that because, you know, Christian Bale is like one of those actors, like you see them, I feel like they kind of like bring a certain weight to like a project, you know what I mean, just because of the types of things that they do. And I feel like Christian Bale is one of those, you know what I mean? He brings a certain excitement to this project just because he's Christian Bale, and I'm interested in seeing his take on this. I think he's a phenomenal actor though, by the way, too.
All I want, you know, that's what I want, you know what I'm gonna say about this, what I want in this movie.
Jamie Alexander?
Exactly. Exactly. No, don't me, Renee. Do not me. How dare you?
Listen, Renee, you know, I want Jamie Alexander in this movie too. Because I love Lady Sif, like the character. Like, yeah. I actually do follow Lady Sif's like comic adventures. Like, once I kind of got, I don't know, like I was playing some random Facebook Marvel game freaking like 10 years ago, and like I think I unlocked like Lady Sif as a character, and like ever since then, like,
I remember that
she's
game.
Had like a cool look, and ever since then, like I just kind of followed her comic exploits, and I'm a Lady Sif fan, you know, so because of that, I'm always like wanting more Lady Sif in the MCU, and equally being disappointed to not get her because she's a very, very not used character, but it's fine. I really want, like, my biggest wish, if any MCU person watches this, which I doubt you won't, my biggest wish would be for them to do like a series that's like Lady Sif and Valkyrie like together, like a buddy cop with them too, you know what I mean, just freaking going on adventures. I love
Across the Nine Realms. Frack, yes, sign me up. I would watch that. I would pay to watch that. Renee, final comments, final thoughts?
Well, I'm really looking forward to it, and I gotta say I love the aesthetic of this trailer. It's very hair metal, especially the like Thor's outfit in when he's with the Guardians, where I'm assuming he's wearing something that Peter had in his closet or something, But he looked very much like a 80s hair metal rocker dude.
Right.
That's funny. It does look exactly like, it's like he got that from Peter or whatever. And it'd be like really funny if like he like had to tailor the freaking sleeves off, had to like ruin Peter's like shirt.
Oh, I didn't think about that. Because like, he's way bulkier than Peter.
Right.
Like something I did notice about this movie, figured out Peter. There's so many freaking characters in this movie.
Yeah.
Like the but, Guardians, you know, Thor. Go ahead.
Okay, continue.
No, I was just like, this would be the also perfect place to bring in Beta Ray Bill, at least with all these characters.
All I was going to say is that, like, it just struck me as you said that, like, yes, there are a lot of characters in it, but it just struck me as you said that, like, how often that recently Marvel movies are just that. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, we're kind of saying that about every Marvel movie now. You know what I mean? Like, think about
like Spider-Man and Doctor Strange.
Right, like,
and then Wanda with Doctor Strange pretty soon.
Right, Spider-Man had a lot of characters, you know, and then we're just coming off of Endgame and all of that, and then like freaking, you know, we had a little break with like Shang-Chi and then the Eternals even had a lot of characters, even though we didn't know any of them, but even that had a lot of characters too, you know.
You're right, I didn't think about that, but I'm like so again, I might think it might be a pacing issue. It seems like it's gonna go through different mythologies, like that's Zeus right there. I'm like, and I was rewatching the Hercules animated series. I'm like, and Hercules met Thor and this guardian god. I'm like, oh, okay, we're doing this, huh? But I'm wondering if that's gonna bring in Hercules too.
Yeah.
To the Avengers.
It's as you said, Renee, because there's a lot of characters, I feel like the narrative is gonna be that pacing that you don't like. Where
it's just like, it's like CJ said, there were too many stories, and I'm like,
too many stories.
Yeah, so I'm like, because so I remember being like, well, what's the main story?
Yeah. So I remember one of them. We're going to have the Guardians, then we're going to have what I'm assuming to be the Greek gods and other gods involved. And then we see Jane.
That's what I'm more excited about, is seeing Jane. Oh, look, she got the muscles. The muscles.
Girl she worked out. Cool.
She looks pretty cool, yeah. In the helmet and all that. She got the helmet. Thor never got the helmet like that she's wearing.
You know that's right? True. Yeah, he never did. We kind of got it in that opening, like when in the little run sequence, he got the Jack Kirby a little bit.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I didn't notice that a little bit.
That better be a longer sequence, Taika.
What if him running?
Yes. Run, Thor, run.
That's a sweet child of mine. Probably.
Oh, I kept running.
Life is full of Mjolnir. You never know when you're gonna strike. That's so stupid. I'm sorry. That might not make it into the episode. CJ, final comments, final thoughts.
I'm interested. I've been waiting for this trailer. You know what I mean? Like I want to see it. I think Chris Hemsworth is a very charismatic actor, and like he just kind of draws you to the screen, you know what I mean? Like he's funny, and especially in Thor, he's been Thor for so long now, like he just like nails it. He can do this, he can play this in his sleep, you know what I mean? Like, and he's fun to watch. Exactly, right? And he's like the last like main Avenger, right? You know what I mean? Like everybody else is gone. Yeah. Like, so it'll be cool to see him back in action. See, I like Thor action when it's good, you know what I mean? So, you know, hopefully they can pull something off. My thoughts are like you, just, you know, I just hope they didn't really give us a sense of the story even in this trailer, you know what I mean? So it's just, you know, I hope they have a decent story and, you know, they just kind of nail it, you know, just focus on it. I do have one more thing to say is like, one thing I like about MCU movies outside of Avengers ones, even though they load them up with characters and cameos and stuff, they really do a good job at making the movie be about the title of the character that it's about.
Sure.
Captain America Civil War had all of the Avengers in it minus Hulk and Thor, but it felt like a Captain America movie, you know what I mean? And I appreciate and I'm in awe at them being able to do that every time, you know what I mean? Even Spider-Man No Way Home had a lot of, you know, cameos and characters, but it felt like a Spider-Man movie, and it felt like a Tom Holland Spider-Man movie. It didn't feel like the other Spider-Man that were in it, you know what I mean? Like, felt like a Spider-Man movie, you know. So I'm hoping that they hold tight to that and that this feels like a Thor movie, even though there's, you know, all this other stuff going on in it.
I'm just surprised it took them this long to release this trailer, because I'm like, we're like 2 months away, 2.5 months away. I'm like, it took us like that long to get this trailer. Like, I remember Spider-Man took a minute too, but it didn't take them this long. I think we had a trailer like 3-4 months before the movie came out. I'm like, why is this so? What's up with that?
It reminds me of the in between No Way Home and not No Way Home, the one before that, Far From Home and Endgame. It reminds me of that as they're trying to market Endgame, but they also had to get a trailer out for Spider-Man because it was coming out soon too.
You right,
know? And it's like they're just really just kind of stumbling over themselves, you know, since the MCU is grown to be such a massive freaking thing.
Yeah, but that's it. That's all I got for thank you for doing. Thank you for reacting to, with me, you guys, to this trailer. We'll see you same freaking time, same freaking channel. Frack off.